إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا إما يبلغن عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما فلا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما وقل لهما قولا كريما واغفض لهما جناح الذل من الرحمة وقل رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Respected brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen Islam for us to live our life. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Anyone who chooses to live his life according to his desires, you know, Allah says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ. If you bring anything other than Islam, then it will not be accepted. So my brothers and elders, our deen teaches us how to do transactions, how to behave, how to talk, how to drink, how to eat, how to marry, how to work, how to do business. Each and everything in our life, you know, one Jew asked Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and how many hours do you worship? So he said, we worship for 24 hours. He said, how is that possible that you can worship for 24 hours? He says that we do everything on the way of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we do it, you know, according to the order of Allah, so it becomes worship for us. So my brothers and elders, today, you know, we think deen, literally in the sense of deen, we think of praying five times, praying tahajjud, growing a beard, you know, wearing an amama, you know, reading Quran, memorizing Quran. You know, we are only, you can say, confined, you know, to all these things. Alhamdulillah, this is part of deen and these are major aspects of deen. But my brothers and elders, what we are missing today, which is ikhlaq, the good character, the ma'amlat, how to do transactions, you know, ma'asharat, how to behave with your family, what are the rights of your wife, what are the rights of your parents, what are the rights of your neighbors, what are the rights of your son and daughter, what are the rights of your siblings. This part, my brothers and elders, today we are missing. You know, today we are missing this part, that this is also part of Islam. This is also part of deen, you know, to smile, you know, give a smile to people. You know, it comes in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to smile at a person is nafli sadaqah. Smile. You know, smile doesn't give even, you know, you don't even talk anything. You just, this is an expression. And this is also sadaqah, charity. So my brothers and elders, today Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, many people, they have fights going on in their family. They have problems going on. Many people, they have things going on with them. Why? Because they are not following complete deen. Complete deen, my brothers and elders, it is 24 hours of life. Allah says in Surah Baqarah, in the first juz, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu udukhulu fis silmi kafa. Enter Islam wholeheartedly. Enter Islam fully. What does it mean? That follow all the commandments of Allah as shown by the way of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Do not follow the footsteps of shaytan, of iblis. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Indeed, he is your open enemy. Iblis is your open enemy. So my brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the biggest blessing Allah can bestow on someone, you know, biggest blessing Allah can bestow on someone is the blessing of Iman. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us Iman, Allah gave us the Kalima, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us as Muslims. And after that, my brothers and elders, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give a certain individual, how can he complete his Iman? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Inna akmalakum imanan ahsanuhum khuluqa. You know, the person who has perfected his Iman is the one who has the best character. Who has the best character? And Rasulullah sallallahu is praised by Allah in the Quran. Innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. Indeed, we have given you the best character. The best character. So my brothers and elders, there are etiquettes how to behave. Human interaction. Human interaction, we need to learn this. You know, like people, they study social sciences. You know, they have different fields now in science. So likewise, my brothers and elders, today we need to learn how do I behave with my mother? How do I, first of all, my brothers and elders, to interact with someone or to honor someone or to give respect to someone, we should know their value. We should know who they are. One hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that near Qiyamah, near the Day of Judgment, my ummah will be involved in two diseases. So one of them will be wahan. Wahan. Ma wahanu ya Rasulullah. What is wahan ya Rasulullah? Hubbu dunya wa karahiyatul maut. That they will love this worldly life and they will hate to die. They will hate to die. Hate to leave this world. And the second thing, my brothers and elders, that Rasulullah says, sakratul jahl. Sakratul jahl. There will be intoxication of illiteracy. It doesn't mean that you will not do masters, you will not be MS, or you will not do bachelors, or you will not go to high school. No, this is not, does not mean that. Sakratul jahl means that they will be illiterate of Allah, illiterate of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They will be illiterate of the life hereafter. So likewise, we do not know today who is Allah, who is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, my brothers and elders, we don't realize that who are our parents. Who are our parents? The parents who are alive today, today because they are alive, we don't value them, we don't respect them. Brothers and elders, when they will leave this world, I have seen many brothers, they are crying now. They say, oh, I wish I served my mother. I wish I served my father. My brothers and elders, Allah, there is ayats which I have recited in Surah Bani Israel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا. And Allah has decided for you that you worship Allah only. Only you worship Allah. And second thing, after Allah's right, Allah is mentioning the right of parents, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And you do ihsan with your parents. You do ihsan with your parents. You do good with your parents. You fulfill their right. You do extra. Ihsan means extra. For example, if I give you a glass of water, and I also give you a glass of water. You give me a glass of water, I give you a glass of water. This is equality. This is justice, adil. And I give you a glass of water and I give you something else. Other than that, this is something more you are giving. Extra. Ihsan. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions regarding how do you behave. إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرُ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. When your parents, they reach to old age. They reach to old age. One of them or both of them. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Do not even say uff to them. Uff, uff. This uff in Arabic, in English we can translate it to no. Don't say no to them. So I'll give you an example. I've been working since morning. I've been, out of the house. After Fajr. Since Fajr I've been out. I come back, around evening time, around 8 o'clock to the house. And my mother says, okay, brother, she's like, oh son, oh my son, can you grab me a glass of water? I'm tired. And I don't want to reply in negative. I'm going to say, no, I don't want to do it. But I make an expression. I say, oh, uff. This uff, the Quran is saying, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا uff. I'm not saying I will not bring water. I'm not saying, no, mommy, please get it yourself. No, I'm not saying this. I'm just making an expression. I'm like, yaar, kya phas gaya, what am I doing? Uff. This uff, Allah is saying, فَلَا. Do not say uff to them. وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. Do not disgrace them. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Talk to them in a soft manner, polite manner, gentle manner, humble manner. Humiliate yourself in front of them. وَغْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. Janah in Arabic means wings. So we don't have wings, we have arms. Allah is saying, وَغْفِضْ لَهُمَا. Put both of your hands, both of your wings with disgrace, in humility in front of your parents. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is trying to explain, وَقْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُرْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا. And make dua for them. رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا. Ay Allah, have mercy on my parents. كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. Like they had mercy on me when I was a kid, when I was a child. My brothers and elders, those who are sitting, who are parents, they know how our parents, they brought us up. You know, it's not easy. It's not easy. You know, I have two daughters myself. You know, when my young one, you know, she's 2 years old, when she's doing all that, I'm like, oh, subhanAllah, how my parents, they brought me up. You know, how, it's not easy. My brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's one sahabi, he's on the deathbed. His name is Alqama radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He cannot recite the kalima on the deathbed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was called and, you know, he was informed that this sahabi is a person who is in the company, suhbat, who has the company of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah mentions in the Quran, وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. I have made promise of Jannah to all the sahaba. They will enter Jannah. All the sahaba, they will enter Jannah. Now this sahabi cannot utter the kalima. His name is Alqama radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, he can talk. He's on the deathbed, he can talk other things. He can see whatever he wants. But he cannot recite the kalima. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasul. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked the sahaba, is his parents alive? So the sahaba replied, no, his father is not present, but his mother, she's alive. So call her or take me to her. So she came, Ummi Alqama radiyallahu ta'ala anha. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked her, are you pleased with your son? Are you pleased with your son? So she said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have no complaints regarding my son for deen. In deen, he is the most obedient servant of Allah. He fasts the whole day. The whole day he's fasting. And in night time, he's in Nawafil. He's praying Tahajjud. And he's making dhikr and he's reading the Quran. But Ya Rasulullah, when he speaks to me, he breaks my heart. He breaks my heart. His words are like, you know, are like wounds of sword. You know, it kills me. You know, it breaks my tears, my heart into pieces. Ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah, he said, O Ummi Alqama, O mother of Alqama, can you forgive your son? Forgive your son. He said, No, Ya Rasulullah. Has given me so much pain, so much hardship, so much, you know, so much inside by his words, I'm hurt. I cannot forgive him. So Rasulullah said to Bilal, oh Bilal, bring some woods. We'll set fire on Alqama. You know, we hope, may Allah forgive him. So say, Rasulullah, you will burn my son? Say, yes, if you don't forgive him, he will be burned in the hellfire. She doesn't know he's on the deathbed. She's living somewhere else. He said, no, Ya Rasul, I cannot see my son burning in the fire. I forgive him. There she says, I forgive him. There Alqama says, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. And my brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa coming back from the graveyard, from kafan dafan, from janaza, he said, O people, listen. The people who are disobedient to their parents, Allah curses on them. The angels curses on them. The humanity curses on them. Their salat is not accepted. There is sadaqah is not accepted. Their fasting is not accepted. My brothers and elders, we need to value our parents. Value our parents. If they are alive, we need to please them. Do service to them. There's one, there are two sahaba. One is Uthman bin Affan, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is the third khalifa. And one is Nu'man bin Haritha, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When Rasulullah ﷺ, he went in Jannah, he heard the recitation of Nu'man bin Haritha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So he asked the angels that Nu'man is still alive, he's in Jannah. You know, how can I hear his recitation? He's living in Medina right now. So the angels replied, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, Nu'man is such a grateful servant of his mother. He does such a noble service to his mother that whenever he recites Quran in Medina, he can be heard in Jannah. He can be heard in Jannah, in paradise. So my brothers and elders, you know, it comes in the hadith that how he used to interact with his mother. Both of them, Uthman bin Affan and Nu'man bin Haritha, they used to wash the clothes of their mother by themselves. You know, I don't wash my clothes myself. They used to wash the clothes of their mother. They used to comb the hair of their mother. They used to comb the hair of their mother. And when their mother used to call Nu'man, she used to go like a servant. It's like, you know, stand like this. Said, Ji, ummi, ji, yes, mom. And listen what his mom is saying. and never used to say, repeat it, used to go back in the other room and ask his wife, what did my mother say? What my mother said. So his wife used to say that your mother was saying this. He said, why did you not say to repeat her? He said, no. If I tell her to repeat her, you know, I will become her disobedient. My brothers and elders, I tell my mother 100 times that what you're saying, can you repeat please? My brothers and elders, we need to learn. These are the Sahaba, these are our role models. This is that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, one of the prophets, Musa alayhi salam, he once asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, who will be my companion in Jannah? Who will be my companion in Jannah? So he said, you know, there is one butcher, he sells meat, he will be your companion in Jannah. He said, Ya Allah, he is Kalimullah, you know, Wakallamullahu Musa Taklima, should talk with Allah. He said, Ya Allah, a butcher will be my companion in Jannah? He said, yes. Ya Allah, can you tell me where he is? Yes, he's in this Falana Bazaar, you know, go to the certain such and such market and he's selling meat. So Musa alayhi salam, he went there and, you know, he saw a butcher, like the butchers there selling meat. So Musa alayhi salam said, can I be in your company? He doesn't know he's Musa. Yeah, sure, he's selling meat. And then, you know, when it's over, the trade is over, he, you know, closes his shop, whatever, and takes some meat and he goes to his house. So Musa alayhi salam follows him. So when he enters the house, you know, he goes in the kitchen, whatever, and he cooks food. And then he enters a room and there's a very old lady. She's lying down on the bed. So he gives support to this lady and then feeds food to this lady. And then this lady, you know, like the old people, they say stuff. So she knows she's saying something, uttering some words which are not understandable. So after that, he feeds her, gives her water, and then, you know, puts her down, lay her down, and then he leaves. So Musa alayhi salam, he asked her, who's this lady and what are you doing? He says, she's my mother. When I go in the morning, I serve her first. Before going to my work, before serving my family, I serve my mother. And when I come back, before visiting my family, my wife, my children, I serve my mother. So Musa alayhi salam, he asked that, what was she saying? What words was she uttering? I cannot understand. So she's saying, mother is mother. You know, the love of mother is love of mother. She's saying, whenever I do service to her, she makes dua and supplication that may Allah make you the companion of Musa in Jannah. May Allah make you the companion of Musa alayhi salam in Jannah. So he says, where is Musa? Where am I? I am a butcher. And Musa is Kalimullah. So my brothers and elders, we can get to a status in Jannah from our ikhlaq. Ikhlaq is such a blessing, such a ni'mah, such a honor, you know, such a dignity from Allah, that if we have good ikhlaq, my brothers and elders, we can win the hearts of people. We don't need to talk. We don't need to give lectures, but because of our ikhlaq, our dealings, you know, how my brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, the Jannah lies underneath the feet of the mother. Jannah lies underneath the feet of the mother. And my brothers and elders, one sahabi, he came, Ya Rasulullah, who has more right upon me, my mother or my father? Said, Ummi, your mother. And then he again asked, Ya Rasulullah, who has more right upon me, my mother or my father? He said, your mother. Third time he asked, Ya Rasulullah, who has more right upon me, my mother or my father? He said, your mother. Fourth time he asked, Ya Rasulullah, who has more right upon me? He said, your father. The fourth time Rasulullah replied, father. My brothers and elders, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has distributed love in a very small percentage has been given to the mother. So my brothers and elders, and one hadith is Rida Rabbi Rida and Walid. You know, it says that the pleasure of Allah is in the pleasure of your father. And there are 8 doors of Jannah. One door of Jannah is the obedience of father. That if you do obedience to your father, it will open for you. And if you be disobedient to your father, this door will close for you. this door will close for you. So my brothers and elders, you know, all the relations that we have today, you know, for example, if our wife dies, our children, we can remarry, we can get a wife again, we can get children again. But mother and father, once they leave this world, my brothers and elders, they can never come back. They have no alternate. They have no replacement. They have no replacement. If they leave, that's it. We are doomed if we have not pleased them. So my brothers and elders, Quran says, you know, again and again, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Don't disgrace them. You know, don't be loud in front of them. You know, in Surah Luqman, Allah teaches us how to have ikhlaq, good ikhlaq. So one of them, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells the quality, you know, Luqman alayhi salam tells us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Luqman that, you know, وَغْضُدْ مِنْ صَوْتِكْ. Talk in a very, very low voice. The pitch of your voice should not be high. إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. Indeed, screaming loudly is like voice of a donkey. So my brothers and elders, we need to correct our ikhlaq. We need to correct our ma'amalat. We need to correct our ma'asharat. You know, how we can do justice between wife and mother. My brothers and elders, a man has more right than anyone. He has more right for his parents, not his wife, for a man. For myself, for you, all the men sitting here, you have the most right upon your parents. If your parents, they tell you anything which is mubah, which is makruh, even the ulama, they say that you can follow them, because, you know, obeying them is fard. Obeying your parents is fard. But my brothers and elders, if they tell you to do disobedience of Allah, then the hadith says, la ta'at al makhluq ila ma'asiyat al khaliq. That you cannot follow the creation when they tell you to disobey the Khalik, the Creator. So my brothers and elders, just imagine the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam is making dua for his father. You know, and saying, oh my father, I will make istighfar for you. And he is an idolater. He is worshipping idols. Even then, Ibrahim alayhi salam is saying that, oh my father, I will make istighfar for you. I will make istighfar for you. And my brothers and elders, the biggest, the sweetest story, the best story in the Quran, أحسن القصص بما أوحينا. The best story in the Quran Allah narrated is the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And in the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, we see that how much love Yaqub and Yusuf they had. And Yusuf alayhi salam was such a dutiful servant of his father. And you know, he had 12 brothers. We know the whole story. So my brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us our parents to earn Jannah. One Sahabi, you know, he went in jihad in the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, in the battle, in war. And his parents were very old. So, you know, Rasulullah ﷺ, you know, he called him back. You know, Rasulullah ﷺ or Ghaliban Hazrat Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu, he called them back. And he said that, are you going for jihad and leaving your old parents back? What kind of jihad is this? So my brothers and elders, serving your parents, being nice to your parents. And Allah mentions the state when they are old. Just imagine this. Imma yablughanna indaka al-kibar. When they are old, each one of them, your mother or your father, because they need you. They need you. My father, myself, I narrated my own story. My father, you know, he just retired in April. You know, 60 years in Pakistan, they retired in 60 years of service. So when he retired, he lives back home, so he comes and visits me. So whenever he calls me, because before he was busy, this is work, you know, he doesn't have time. I used to call him, like, no, I'm busy, I'll call you later. But now he's free. You know, he calls me, you know, every day, twice or thrice. So if I'm busy, you know, I feel that he needs me now. You know, before, because he was busy himself, but now, you know, he's nothing to do, he's retired. So my brothers and elders, when they are in old age, when they are old, Quran exclusively mentions the old age. Exclusively. عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما فلا تقل لهما أف. And once Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, when will Qiyamah occur? When the day of judgment will come? He said, Allah knows. قُلْ إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ إِنَّ اللَّهِ Allah knows, Allah has the knowledge. So he said, no, give us some signs. He said, أَنْتَ لِدُ الْأَمَةَ رَبَّتَهَا When you see that the daughters are disobedient to their mothers, then remember that Qiyamah will occur. My brothers and elders, when the daughters, you know, the sons are usually, they are disobedient, but when the daughters are telling their mothers, then don't bark, you know, shut up, and you don't know all these nasty things, you know, they are talking to their mother like they talk to a two-year-old, you know, and the mother and father, they're crying, they can't do anything. So my brothers and elders, the parents themselves, they also need to learn. You know, this deen just not teaches us the rights of parents, but also teaches us the rights of children as well. You don't give time in the house. You're working 8 hours, 10 hours. You come in the house, you sleep, eat, drink, dinner, and again you sleep. And on the weekend, you're doing some errands. So my brothers and elders, hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Akrimu awladakum. Akrimu awladakum. Do ikram to your children. Have mercy on your children. You know, treat them in a good way. Don't insult them in front of everyone. They have self-ego. Children have self-ego. Small, one-year-old, two-year-old, they have self-ego. If you, you know, scold them and you be harsh to them and you raise your voice, they will learn what you are doing. My brothers and elders, if a daughter, if a girl, she looks at his mother, because the role model for the daughter is her mother. So if she looks in the lifestyle of the mother, and she prays for 5 minutes, 5 minutes she's done with the Isha Salah. And when she does makeup, she does for 1 hour. You know, she curls her hair, she puts up eyeliner, this, that. So the daughter, she gets an idea that doing makeup, this is something important. Praying five minutes, you can pray, that's fine. If you don't pray, that's fine. So my brothers and elders, you know, I was in Wyoming. I went for Eid there. So one of the brothers was asking me, you know, mashallah, Muslim brother, that brother Faizan, do you eat halal, right? You eat halal, right? That was the question. You eat halal, right? So this is we are right now. This is our ahwal, our conditions. A Muslim is asked, and he knows I'm the Imam. I came for Eid. He's asking me, do you eat halal? You eat halal, right? Or wrong. You can eat KFC as well. Like, no. So my brothers and elders, we need to focus on our family. We need to focus, you know, to give time to our children. Our children, they need time from us. They need time from us. And the children, they need to give time to their parents. You know, my brothers and elders, when their children, they are young, you know, we don't give time to them. And when they become old, now we cry that, you know, they don't give time to us. Why? Because you never give time to them. You know, it's vice versa. It's vice versa. If you give them time, they will give you time. If you respect them, wallahi al-azim, I'll give you and narrate you my story, small story. My parents, they were visiting me 2 months ago from Pakistan, my mother and my father. So at night time, I used to massage the feet of my mother. Every night, you know, before I sleep, go to my bed in my room with my wife, I used to massage the feet. So my young one, my daughter, she's almost two. So she used to come in the room. She said, what Baba is doing? She's looking, you know, Baba is massaging the feet. 2 days ago, you know, I said to my daughter, I'm not talking to you. You're being very, you know, harsh and, you know, this and that. So she started massaging my feet. So what you do, they will do as well. What they watch, you know, one of my uncles in Pakistan, when I visited them, he was saying that, look, my daughter, she can dance on this song. And he's very proud. And he's telling me to look, you know, she, mashallah, she copies this actress so well. And, you know, she's such a good imitator. So my brothers and elders, we need to see that whatever mahal, whatever environment we give to our children, they will do that. You know, they are very adaptful. They are very, you know, volatile. Whatever you give them, they will take it. If you give them deen, they will take it. They will be deendar. You know, even if they live in America, even if they're born here, you know, we see children, you know, many of you go back home, You see children, they are in worse condition. And over here, children, they are more pious. Why? Because the environment there, you know, back home in back home countries, the environment there is not suitable. It's not something, you know, which is, you know, which is good for the environment, for the tarbiyat, for the nourishment of your children. So my brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to Jibreel, he said, Qiyamah will occur when you see the children, they will be disobedient to their parents. They will be disobedient to their parents. So my brothers and elders, this is a blessing that we have today. Wallahi al-azim, it's a blessing. We cannot comprehend, we cannot think that how much blessing Allah has given us. What a blessing Allah has provided me. The people who have left their, you know, the people who don't have their parents alive today, ask them that what they're missing in their life, what they're missing, and what we have, ni'mah. So my brothers and elders, you know, we need to work on our ikhlaq. We need to work on our ikhlaq. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he addresses us again and again in the ahadith, how to be dutiful, how to react with your wife, how to react with your mother, how to fulfill the right of your children, how to fulfill the right of your neighbors, how to fulfill the right of your brother, how to fulfill the right of your sister. You know, one hadith says, "Wali nafsika alayka haq." Your body has right upon you. You know, I was talking to a doctor, and he was telling me that a normal person, has to sleep for 6 to 8 hours, at least 6 hours. In medical terms, you know, 6 hours at least. If he's not sleeping, then obviously, you know, you see his when he talks, you know, see he's always in the mood of fighting. You know, he's always hyper, he's always angry because his sleep is not done. Obviously, he's not in good physical health. So my brothers and elders, wali zawjika alayka haq, your wife has a right upon you. Wali ummika alayka haq, your mother has a right upon you. Wali abika alayka haq, your father has a right upon you. Wali akhika alayka haq, your brother has a right upon you. Wali jarika alayka haq, your neighbor has a right upon you. Your neighbor has a right upon you. So my brothers and elders, you know, inshallah, one story I will narrate, inshallah, finish my talk. Rasulullah, you know, there were one father and son at the time of Rasulullah. And the father, you know, he used to take the wealth, the money of the son, used to use it. So the son was very mad, you know, and he complained regarding his father in the majlis, in the gathering, and to Rasulullah, that, Ya Rasulullah, my father, he spends all my wealth. He spends all my wealth. So Rasulullah, he said, okay, call your father. So on the way, when the father was coming, he said some poetry. He said some, in the Arabs, they were poet, you know, that's where you see the Quran, you know, everything ending, Noon, Meem, Ar-Rahman, Allama al-Quran, Khalaqa al-Insan, Allamahul. You know, this is why you see the Quran, no one can make one ayah compared to the Quran. This is a mu'ajiza, a miracle, that the book, the Kalamullah. So this, his father, he was saying some verses, you know, in Arabic language, in his heart. He did not utter from his tongue, in his heart he was saying. And my brothers, and on the way, he was thinking these, that, you know, when you were young, I fed you, you know, when there was daytime, you know, it was heat, and I was trying to get halal rizq for you, and I used to take you to the park, and I used to do this to you, and I did this favor to you, and now when you are old, you are telling me I cannot use your wealth. You know, this is a summary what he was saying. So when he came in the majlis, in the gathering of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Jibreel salam came down. He said, Ya Rasulullah, ask this man right there sitting, that what did he utter in his heart? Tell him to say the poetry, say the words, the ash'ar, the verses that, you know, Arabic verses that he was saying regarding his son. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. وأشهد أنك رسول الله. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that you can be the prophet of Allah. No one can tell this. Who can tell you that what's in your heart you're thinking? So now he said the ash'ar. And my brothers and elders, Rasulullah, when he was listening to the poetry of the father, the verses, what he said, out of out of the sadness and sorrow because his son complained. You know, the muhaddithin, they write that Rasulullah, he was crying. And he says, you and your wealth belongs to your father, go away. You and your wealth belongs to your father. My brothers and elders, today we have value of dollar, value of car, value of the house, value of wife and children. But unfortunately, we don't have value for our parents. You know, they are, you know, they are looking for us that my son will sit with me for 10 minutes. And son doesn't have time. He's busy. You know, I used to be in Karachi in Pakistan. And one alim was giving bayan, and he was saying that this was the habit of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he used to visit his aunt, Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha. Apni puppi ke paas jaate milne. His puppi, his aunt, used to visit her. So my brothers and elders, today we need a lot of time to give to our family for their tarbiyat, you know, for their nourishment, for how they can be upraised in an environment which is suitable, you know, to implement deen in our life. My brothers and elders, may Allah give first of all tawfiq to myself. You know, we are all in need. We are all, you know, kullu bani adama khattaun. All the human beings, they are sinners, they make mistakes. وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. The best sinners are the one who make tawbah, who repent to Allah. So my brothers and elders, till now, if I have not pleased my parents, if they are upset with me, with anything I have done, you know, it's a humble request, who are listening, the brothers, that I call them, I visit them, you know, I you know, beg them, I hold their feet, ask, oh my mother, I ask forgiveness. Whatever I have done till now, please forgive me. And my brothers and elders, if your mother makes dua for you, wallahi al-azim, if she makes dua for you, you got everything in the life. You don't need anything. If your parents, they make dua for you. And my brothers and elders, last thing inshallah, that one is requesting for dua. That I call my mother, I say, oh, my mother, please make dua for me. One is calling them and requesting them for dua. And one is acting in such a manner that they make dua by their heart, by themselves. You don't need to request them. From the core of the heart, inside heart, he makes dua. Ya Allah, my son, my daughter. Ya Allah, have mercy on them. Ya Allah, give them barakah. Ya Allah, give them rizq. Give them awlad. From the core of the heart, they will make dua. You don't need to request them, but act in a manner. Serve them in such, with nobility, with humility, with disgrace. You know, وَقْفِضَ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. With mercy, with love, with affection. You know, serve them in such a manner that they make dua by themselves. You don't need to tell them, please make dua for me. No, they will make dua. So my brothers and elders, may Allah give us tawfiq, inshallah, to implement these talks in our life and to be dutiful to our parents, inshallah. And my brothers and elders, if they are not alive, for example, they are not alive, we make isale sawab for them. You know, whatever we read the Quran, we do dhikr, we make dua, we do sadaqah, charity, we ask Allah to, Allah, give this reward to my parents. And the ulama, they have written books on this, that those people whose parents are not alive, even if they were disobedient to Allah, if they make istighfar for them and they do isale sawab, you know, they send all these good deeds to them, they will become obedient. You know, in the paper of Allah, that they are obedient of their parents in the court of Allah. If they do isale sawab. So if they are not alive, we make dua for them. If they are alive, we make do service to them. Be humble, be polite. You know, don't ever be harsh to them. Don't even talk loud to them. You know, don't even talk loud to them. Hassan and Hussein. Hassan used to be at the front, Hussein used to be at the back. Ali radiallahu anhu used to walk. So Hassan used to say, if someone attacks at my father from the front, I am there protecting him. If someone, you know, attacks at him in the night time, in the darkness from the back, I am there. So in the middle, they used to walk. They do never, some people, the pious people, they did not used to walk in front of their father. They have adab, etiquettes, have adab. Ad-deenu kulluhu adab. Deen is nothing but adab. You know, how to live your life. My brother, may Allah give us tawfiq, inshallah, to implement these talks in our life, convey to the whole of humanity. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.